Hi students, welcome to the next session of our 8th class physics. Today we are going to start a new chapter, that is 7th chapter, that is coal and petroleum. Before going to start what the main topic of this lesson, we have to discuss some prerequisite concept, that is what are the things which are used in our olden days, that is our grandfathers and our fathers and grandfathers used to use different things, and nowadays how the same substances for the same purpose, what are the substances that we are using. Okay, for example, whenever I am just concerned about the water pipe, suppose, okay, in olden days they used to made by the iron, nowadays we are going to use with the plastic. In the same way, chair, what we are sitting, most of the times we will use the plastic chairs, but in olden days they used to be made with wood or iron. Okay, such type of differences, and what are the differences of the usage of the things of the same material, same type of substances, and the materials, change in the materials in olden days, and what are the change that what we are using nowadays, that what we are going to discuss as the initial segment of this lesson. Okay, all of you go to page number 94 please. Here, as an activity 1, we have a table. Okay, see, have a look at the table 1. Column A gives the name of some articles and items. Ask your grandfathers or other older people about the name of the materials which you used for the items given in column A, and write them in column B. Then in column C, write the name of the materials being used at present. Okay, so what is the purpose of in this table? Page number 94 table consists of some articles or activities. For attaining these activities, what are the materials is used in olden days, that is 40-50 years ago, and what are the materials that we are using for the same activity, for fulfilling the same activity, what are the materials we are using, that what we are going to discuss as a beginning of the lesson. Now coming to this, for example, coming to the first one, the containers for storing the pickles. Go through the book, page number 94 from your textbook. See, the first column, the first row is containers for storing pickles is the activity. For that purpose, which type of materials are used in 30-40 years ago? Here we used to use 30-40 years ago, we might have used clay jars, but nowadays we use plastic containers. Am I right? Everywhere, for every activity, most of the activities or most of the substances that we are using nowadays is made up of plastic. Okay, now packing food for a journey. In olden, when we are going outside in a journey, sometimes there is a need of taking our food along with us. Okay, and in that purpose, in olden days we used to have the copper tiffin boxes or stainless steel tiffin boxes, where here in nowadays we use the plastic tiffin boxes. Okay, water pipes in the houses. The water pipes in the houses in olden days were made with iron. You see, if you see any old house, you can able to see the water pipe connection is made with iron. But nowadays we use plastic, PVC, and iron also. Sometimes there is a necessity of using the iron also. But most of the water pipe connection is made with PVC. Now hair comb in olden days it is used with wood, it is made with wood, and nowadays we are using plastic. Vessels for cooking food, that time they used to use copper or aluminium vessels. Okay, nowadays we will use stainless steel utensils, that is steel utensils nowadays we use. Of course, sometimes we will use aluminium substances also, aluminium materials also. Now fuel used to cook food. Now olden days they used to use coal, wood, In olden days, we used to use wood and coal for cooking the food. But nowadays, what we use, that already we know, we use the LPG gas cylinders. That is LPG cylinders. Most of the houses have the LPG gas cylinders. Okay. Or even now we will use electric stoves, electric induction cookers or electric rice cookers, that what we use in some houses. Okay. Fuel used in a train engine. In olden days, the fuel which is used for in a train engine was a coal, but nowadays we will use, after the technology has been improved, they used to change from coal to diesel. Diesel engines will be used nowadays. In some railway track, in some routes of the railway track, they will use even electric engines also. The difference you can find. Okay, if you go to any holy place, or if you have a train journey, we have of two type of engines will be used. That is, one is running with the diesel, and one is running with some engines will run with the electricity. Okay, luggage for carrying the clothes. In olden days, we used to have a metal trunks. We used to have metal trunks, but nowadays we use plastic suitcases and plastic bags. That the bags we will use, or we will use suitcases which are made up of plastic. Okay, water buckets. We use water buckets. In olden days, they used to use with iron pots or clay pots. Now we will use plastic buckets, plastic vessels and all. Okay, water storage in houses. In water store, to store the water in houses, in olden days they used to use clay pots, but nowadays we use plastic buckets, sometimes stainless steel vessels and stainless steel pots and all. Okay, constructing material. In olden days, in order to construct the houses, they used to use bricks, sand and clay. Okay, they used to use bricks, sand and clay, but nowadays as a construction material, they use bricks, sand and cement. There is a change in the materials which we are using. Jewelry, that time they used to use gold and silver. Nowadays we use gold, silver and platinum. Furniture, that is chair and beds which are made up of wood. Nowadays it is made up of wood and plastic. These are some activities and the materials, difference in the materials which are used in olden days and nowadays. I hope you understood this. The next segment, and we notice that there is a difference in the materials that what we are using in previous days and these days. Okay, we have a long list in if you go to the page number 95, see, from the activity you have a long list of materials. Some of them, like wood material, that is iron, silver, gold, etc., were used 10 years, 50 years and even 100 years ago. Okay, some materials are there where we are using now also. They were used 100 years, 50 years, 10 years ago also. We have used that type of materials. Gold, in 100 years ago also we used, now also we are using. Silver, 100 years ago also we used, now also we are using. Okay, like that, iron used 100 years ago, now is material science. See, as the technology, the science and technology is getting improved, we have a special branch in science. Okay, see, the progress in the science and technology gives us new products every day. As the technology improves, there is the invention of new products every day, and the branch of science which deals with materials is called material science. The branch of science which is used which deals with materials is called material science. The branch of science which is used to deal with materials are called as material science. Now we have to discuss about the source of materials. What is the main source of all these materials? See here, already we have compared the differences between the materials that we have used. All these materials, from where does they come? They come from. Okay, if I take iron, where it is coming from? If I take gold, where it is coming from? If I concern the silver, where that silver is going to come from? Okay, if I take the clay pots, where they are going to come from? Wood, where they are going to come from? If as we are habituated to use the plastic items, how does this plastic, where, from where does this plastic has come? That is what we are going to, that is the main, from where we are going to extract our desired materials, that main thing is called a source. A source of the materials. That's what we are going to discuss now. See, the materials used early were obtained from soil. Okay. Now, whenever the materials in olden days, if it is a clay pot, where does the clay is come from? Suppose clay, where does the clay has come from? It came from soil. Okay, the clay pots are going to come from the soil. Okay, that is, now water we have the respective sources, but when I take the gold, silver, iron, etc. were extracted. Okay, they will be extracted from their respective ores. Okay, now ore is a substance which is present in the earth crust. Ore is a substance which is present in the earth crust, which consists of the raw form of these materials. Okay, the exactly gold cannot be present in the earth. The gold is present in respective ore. The silver is present in the form of its respective ore. Iron is present in the form of respective ore. This ore is processed. This ore is processed with different methods. Ore is processed with different methods to extract the desired material. Okay, what is ore and all, we will be discussing about this ore in higher classes even more better. Consider that ore is a source of materials in which the respective materials are present in a raw form. Okay, see here, soil, water and air were not only the sources of materials used early, but also sources of energy. Okay, water, the sunlight, the wind, that all the sources of different materials, but these are also considered as the sources of energy. Now, we use plastic. See, now plastic has replaced many materials used earlier, that already we have discussed. Everywhere, if it is a wooden chair, nowadays we are using plastic. If it is a comb with made up of wood, now we are making with the plastic. If anything which is made up of iron, some water pipe which is made up of iron, we are using nowadays with the plastic. That means most of the materials which were used olden days were replaced by the plastic. The plastic has, as the technology has been getting improved, the plastic is replacing all the substances, all the products. Okay, now where does this come from? Now plastic is obtained. Plastic is obtained from petrochemicals, that already we have discussed synthetic fibers. Okay, synthetic fibers and plastics lesson. Okay, if not, we will come back with that. Plastic is obtained from, it's a petrochemical, it is a chemical which is processed in different methods in order to abstract or in order to get this plastic. Simple, keep in mind that the different materials, whatever we are using to serve, to fulfill our activities, that materials from where they would be obtaining, from where they were obtained, that is called as source of the material. It is clay is obtained from, clay is used for different, clay is a material which is used for having the different purposes. It is obtained from soil, gold, silver and iron and different metals are extracted from the respective ore, where this ore present in earth crust, it is available in earth. It present in earth crust, okay. And they have different methods which are used to extract this materials from the raw form of the gold, silver and iron in the ore. There we can use different methods in order to extract that pure form of that pure form of this materials. Now plastic is obtained from petrochemicals. I hope you understood this session. Now what we discuss, this source, some these sources all can be classified into natural sources and artificial sources. Okay, the source of material, suppose if I say soil, water, air, petrol also one of the source which is used in automobiles. Okay, the soil, water air, petrol, etc. are called natural sources. Then what is the artificial source? Okay, petrochemical, where it is, this petrochemical is a chemical which is used or which is obtained, which is made in industries, laboratories. Okay, they will be extracted in labs, that is made by human. So this type of petrochemicals are considered as artificial or synthetic sources. Okay, next go to page number 95, table 2. This table gives consists of two columns, where in one column we have a material and in other column we have the how it is obtained segment. Suppose glass, how the glass is obtained? By melting the sand with other materials and then cooling it rapidly. Okay, by melting the sand and other materials then cooling it rapidly, we will obtain glass. And how the clay is obtained? Actually general, the major raw substance of that is soil. Even more detail if we discuss how it is obtained, that is by mixing the mineral kaolinite. By mixing the mineral kaolinite with water, we will obtain clay. What is kaolinite? Kaolinite is a substance where it is used for abstracting the clay. And kaolinite in Telugu we can call as matti, some type of matti. Okay, wood. How that wood is obtained? It is from dry trees. The wood is obtained from dry trees. We are going to obtain the wood. And plastic, already we have discussed, plastic is obtained from petrochemicals. And metals, this also already we discussed, metals like gold, silver, iron and some other metals, they are going to obtain from their respective ores. Okay, this is what is the sources of materials and how they are going, the respective materials are going to be obtained. The next topic of this lesson is exhaustible and inexhaustible resources. Depending on the availability of the resources, they are classified into exhaustible resources and inexhaustible resources. Okay, before going to study about what are the exhaustible resources, we will have a glance look, we have a first look on inexhaustible resources, that is the resources which are available
unlimited or which are available unlimited, or if the resources is not going to end its source, even we are going to use them for as much as we can use, that type of sources we can call as inexhaustible resource. Now, among them, what is the best example of inexhaustible resource? That is, the wind energy is an inexhaustible resource, and solar energy also inexhaustible resource. What does it mean? That is, if I use solar energy, will it going to end someday? No, it will not. Today, if I use solar energy, tomorrow also I can use. Day after tomorrow, until the solar energy is available, that much solar energy I can use. That is endless usage. In how much I can use? There is a production of new energy. There is a production of, again, there is a production of solar energy. That is, there is no end to the production of solar energy. That type of resources are considered as solar energy. Now, wind energy is also one of the inexhaustible resource. How much we use the wind energy? That is abundantly available. The plenty of wind energy we have in our nature, and these two type of wind energy and the solar energy are also considered as natural resources. They are available naturally. This type of resources are called as natural resources. Now, where do we use this wind energy? Okay, we have a Duino segment. We have a Duino segment in page number 96 of our textbook. That is, wind is an important natural resource. Wind is an important natural resource. Sailboats and sailing ships have been using wind power since thousands of years. Not only from these days, from since thousands of years also, this wind energy will be used by this sailing ships and sailing boats. Windmills were used to grind corn and pump the sea water to make salt. From the sea, in order to pump the water to the bank of the sea bank, okay, we use the wind energy, which is a natural resource. This is the definition, this is the usage of the inexhaustible resource and the examples. If you go with the definition, that is, the resources which are unlimited and abundantly available in nature are called inexhaustible resources. Okay, they are available in abundantly and they are available unlimited. How much we will use, that much it is available. There is no end of the production of that resource, that energy. Okay, I hope you understood. Next we go with exhaustible resources. That is, the resources which are limited in nature. There is some limitation of that resources in nature and can be exhausted. That is no longer available. After using that, they will be exhausted and they will no longer available by the human activity are called exhaustible resources. The resources which are limited and they can be, there is no longer available after the use by the human activity, that type of resources we call as exhaustible resources. Example is coal and petroleum are the best examples of exhaustible resources. That is, if I use coal, how much available, that much I can use after there is no much production, that is, that exhausts. Okay, petroleum also, how much we use, that much after availability, there is a limitation of the production of that petroleum. Okay, so someday, not today, someday there is a chance of getting exhausted of these exhausted resources. Where inexhaustible resources, there is no end, there is no day where this wind energy is going to end, there is no particular limited day where the solar energy is going to end. That type of energies we are calling as inexhaustible. And coal, there might be some day where these resources have an end. That type of resources we call as exhaustible resources. Now, what happens to this coal and petrol if we use more and more? Okay, if coal and petroleum etc. are the energy sources which are exhaustible and usage. Okay, if this situation continues in future, we might have to depend on solar energy. If these two energy resources are vanished, okay, in future we have to depend on these inexhaustible resources. That is, now is wood an inexhaustible resource? Think about that. Okay, now what will happen if all the forests are cut down and the wood is used for various purposes? Think that all the forest has been cut down and that wood is used for various purposes, and think that how long do you think it would take to grow the forest again? Imagine if we cut off all the forests and think how much time it will take to grow the forest. Okay, there are many resources like trees which will be depleted if we do not make judicious use of them. Okay, if we are not going to use for the right purposes and in a limited manner, there is a chance of the wood also is getting exhaustible. Okay, see, not only that, we need petroleum not just as a fuel. Okay, we use petroleum, the petroleum products are diesel and petrol. Petroleum is a chemical, petrochemical, where it is from this we can have various fuels, various substances can be extracted from this petroleum. Among them, petrol and diesel are some fuels, are the substances which are acting like a fuels for, okay. We need petroleum not just as a fuel. Okay, this petroleum is not used as just as a fuel, but also which is used for several other purposes. Okay, what are the several other purposes that we will discuss in the next coming up classes? That means if we come to a conclusion, that is, the resources which are available abundantly, that are called as inexhaustible. The resources which there, if there is a limitation for that availability of that resources, are called as exhaustible resources. That type of example is coal and petroleum. Inexhaustible resources are wind energy and solar energy. Okay, as an activity, just small activity, that what we have to write in page number 96 in table 3, we have what are the exact, that is, resources which are available, abundantly available, that we have to write here. The resources which are limited, that also we have to write here. You can take the help of the control rate is more than the production rate. Production is less and consumption is more. So there might be so much difficult in the products which are used, the substances which are dependent on the oil and petroleum. Okay, now we have, what will happen if the fossil fuel like coal and petroleum are completely exhausted? Suppose there is a scenario, or we come to a situation where if this coal and petroleum get exhausted, what would be the future energy resource? That is what the questions which are stated. Okay, the entire research and development, that is R&D, in the field of source of energy shows that at present rate of usage of the conventional energy sources like fossil fuel will not last for long. Okay, the consumption of, by this rate of consumption of fossil fuel, that is coal and petroleum, some fossil fuels, okay, will not last for long. There is a nearby situation where they are going to end. Presently, only 10% of non-commercial energy resources like solar energy, wind energy, tidal energy, etc. are used. As we have abundant energy of wind energy, solar energy and tidal energy, okay, we are using only 10% of this. Okay, these are inexhaustible resources and abundantly available. As they are inexhaustible resources and abundantly available, we have to focus on these more in order to preserve these inexhaustible resources for our future needs.